President Trump and congressional Republicans have made a lot of promises about their tax plan. It's focused on the middle class. It's not. It won't benefit the rich. It will. It's bad for Trump's family fortune. Not even close. They also keep claiming, despite the $1.4 trillion price tag, that the tax cuts will pay for themselves. And even more, they say it will actually help pay down the national debt. How? By boosting economic growth so high that government revenues will increase from taxes, even as businesses and households pay a smaller share of their incomes to the government. Numerous Republicans say that tax cuts need only boost the economy by 0.4% a year from current levels to cover the price tag of their tax plan. How hard can that be? Well, apparently, it's really hard. There have been huge changes made to our tax code throughout U.S. history, yet we've seen no observable shift to long-term growth rates in the last 150 years, which have hovered at an average rate of between 1.8 and 2% growth per year. But don't take our word for it. Studies by the Tax Policy Center, Moody's Analytics, and Penn's Wharton School of Business all found that the congressional tax plans will increase U.S. debt between $1.3 and $2.1 trillion over a decade. Even the Conservative Tax Foundation, which is in favor of the GOP plans, estimates between $500 billion and $1 trillion of additional debt. To a T, they all say that slashing taxes now while keeping government spending at current levels will only widen a hole in the U.S. budget. Don't believe them? Try this. A poll of 42 leading economists found that not a single one thinks this tax plan will pay for itself. Tax cuts, any tax cuts, sure sound great, but if we're going to bust the bank to enact them, we should be honest about what they're going to cost us.